So in this video, we're going to do what is really the main algorithm of matrix algebra, the algorithm that computers spend an awful lot of time working on. And that's the algorithm for solving a system of linear equations. Because we're doing it by hand, we're considering these small baby systems. So this is three equations and three unknowns. But on a computer, you would be doing thousands of equations and thousands of unknowns. And then you need a very efficient algorithm in order to do it quickly. So that algorithm is called Gaussian elimination. So I want to kind of step you through the algorithm in the video today. So there are no matrices when we write down a system of equations. But I think you've seen a little bit of this already. But you know, the main reason for matrices is to represent linear systems of equations. So how do we do that? So the first equation is the first row of the matrix. So you take the coefficients, minus 3, 2, minus 1, and then multiplies the unknown vector, x1, x2, x3. So this is why we define matrix multiplication the way that we did. We have minus 3x1 plus 2x2 minus x3. So that's equal to the right-hand side, which is minus 1. Okay, so the first equation is represented by the first row of the matrix. And then the second equation becomes the second row, 6 times x1 minus 6 times x2 plus 7 times x3 equals minus 7. And the last equation becomes the third row, 3x1 minus 4x2 plus 4x3 equals minus 6, okay? So that's the usefulness of matrices here. We can represent this system by a matrix equation. Sometimes we just write this simply as A, the matrix A times the vector X is equal to the right-hand side B, right? AX equals B. That's our equation. Okay, so what is the Gaussian elimination algorithm? I can tell you the first step and then explain to you the algorithm. The first step is to form what's called the augmented matrix. Augmented matrix. And that's our A matrix with the right-hand side B attached to the last column. So that's the matrix minus 3, 2, minus 1, and then we attach minus 1, 6, minus 6, 7, and then we attach minus 7, and 3, minus 4, 4, and we attach minus 6. So that's called the augmented matrix, okay? Now the idea is to do some operations on this matrix to make this system of linear equations easy to solve. So what are we allowed to do? So what are we allowed to do to the system of equations that doesn't change the solution? We can change the order of the equations. That's the same thing as changing the order of the rows of the matrix, okay? We can multiply any equation by a number, by a constant. That's the same as multiplying a row by a constant, okay? And then the last operation, which is the most important operation, is that we can multiply one of the equations by a constant and add it to another equation, okay? So for instance, we can multiply both sides of the first equation by 2 and add it to the second equation. So the left side to the left side, the right side to the right side, okay? So that's what we're going to do. We're going to take this matrix, and then we're going to try to add rows by a constant and add it to rows underneath so that we will bring this matrix to upper triangular form. At least the A part of this matrix, we want to bring it to upper triangular. If we do that, the solution will be very easy. Okay. So we start here. This is called the pivot position. So that's the pivot. Let me write it here. That's the pivot. Okay. And we have to eliminate all the numbers below the pivot. So we want to get rid of the 6 right below the pivot. To do that, we can multiply the first row by 2 and add it to the second row. And then the 6 will become 6 minus 6, which will give us a 0. So let's do that. So this matrix then goes into the first row, minus 3, 2, minus 1, minus 1. And then the second row, we multiply the first row by 2 and add it to the second row. So we get our 0 here, right? That's the point. And then we have a 4 minus 6 is minus 2. And then we have minus 2 plus 7 is 5. And then we have minus 2 minus 7 is minus 9. Okay, so we got the number below the pivot. We got a 0 below the pivot. And then the last row, we also want to get a 0 below the pivot. So we just add the first row to the last row, will get us a 0. So we have 0 minus 3 plus 3. 2 minus 4 is minus 2. Minus 1 plus 4 is 3. And minus 1 minus 6 is minus 7. Okay? So we've used our pivot here, our minus 3, to eliminate all the numbers below the pivot. Now we find the next pivot. So the next pivot will be this number here, because we're trying to get to upper triangular. So we're trying to eliminate everything below this upper triangular matrix here. So we need to eliminate this minus 2 down here. So how do we do that? We multiply the second row by minus 1 and add it to the third row. So the first row stays the same. That's a minus 3, 2, minus 1, minus 1. The second row stays the same. That's a 0, minus 2, 5, minus 9. And then we multiply the second row by minus 1 and add it to the third row. So we get 0, 0, and then minus 5 plus 3 is minus 2, and then 9 minus 7 is 2. Okay? Then we have our upper triangular matrix here, right? So let me sketch that out. That's the upper triangular matrix. So that's the goal of Gaussian elimination, to do operations on this augmented matrix to bring this A matrix to upper triangular form, okay? When we do that, we have a system of equations now. So we have each row represents one equation. So let's write the equation. So we have minus 3x1 plus 2x2 minus x3 equals minus 1. Okay, that's the same as our original equation. The second equation now is minus 2x2 plus 5x3 equals minus 9. The third equation is minus 2x3 equals 2. Okay, so this is our upper triangular system. The idea here is the solution of this system now is very fast compared to the solution of the original system. So it's really, you have to think computationally. The idea here is that the computer can solve this very fast. Okay, that means few operations to solve this system. So you start at the bottom. So the method of solution here is called back substitution. okay, because you start at the bottom, substitution. You start at the bottom and work your way forward. So the bottom is x3 equals minus 1, right? And then the second equation, we solve for x2. So you can write it down immediately that x2, you divide by minus 2, so minus 1 half. And you throw everything onto the right-hand side. So we have minus 5x3 minus 9. And then you substitute in the previous found solution. So that's the beauty of back substitution, is everything you need as you work your way up, you already have. So here we have x3 equals minus 1. So we have plus 5 minus 9 is minus 4. Divided by minus 2 is 2. So the solution here is 2, okay? Finally, the first equation, we have x1. And then we're dividing by minus 3. So minus 1 over 3. And then we're throwing everything to the right-hand side. Let me do the order that we've solved. So we have x3 minus 2x2, and then minus 1 at the end. Okay? And then we plug in the numbers. So x3 is minus 1, x2 is 2. So minus 1 minus 4 is minus 5, minus 1 is minus 6, minus 6 divided by minus 3 is 2. Okay? And that completes the solution. We can write down the solution if we want. So we have x1, x2, x3 is equal to x1 is 2, x2 is 2, x3 is minus 1. Okay, Gaussian elimination. So you have a system of n equations and n unknowns, supposed to be a unique solution. You can write that system as AX equals B. So here we say A will be an invertible matrix. So the solution will be X equals A inverse B, at least formally. But it's much faster to actually solve using Gaussian elimination. You form an augmented matrix, so you take your A and you attach to it B as the last column. Then you do operations that are allowed with the goal of converting the augmented matrix into an upper triangular matrix, at least the A part of that matrix to upper triangular. Then when you end up with the upper triangular system of equations, it's very easy to solve. You use back substitution. You start with the last equation and work your way upwards. And then you have all of the solutions as you keep going, and then you find the solution. Okay, a very, very important algorithm for large-scale computation. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.